given the input of combinational circuit. Alright? And to trigger a flip-flop, we are going to apply a clock signal. We know that flip-flop is edge trigger, right? It can be triggered either on positive edge or the negative edge, right? Now, as I have told you that a D, capital D, is a function of W and Q. Alright? Z. What is Z? Z is my output, right? So, Z is the only function of Q. Why? Because output Z depends only on the present state, right? Now, F and G, what are these? These are the Boolean functions. So, we can conclude that my output only depends on the current state, that is Q. Right? So what is my input? Input is my Q. What is my output? Output is my Z. Alright? What is my current state? Or again, the present state, which is Q. And what is my next state? Next state is D. Alright? Now, how to draw a state graph? This is the example of state graph in which you can see there are total three states. S0, S1 and S2, right? S0 means 00, 01 and 10, right? So what do you mean by these three states? So in the circle, you can see over here, in the circle, it is my present state, right? Apart from that, as this state diagram, what it will show? It will show based on which input, either it is 0 or 1, what is my output and what is my next state. So we are representing that thing with the help of this state diagram. So in the circle, it represents the present state. In the outermost side of circle, it represents the inputs. So based on which input, my output is going to be changed and my state is going to be changed, right? So, what is W? W is my input. What is Z? Z is my output, right? So, based on which input, my output is going to be changed. Over here, first focused on the S0. What is S0? S0, that means 00. That is my present state, right? So, based on that present state, if input is equals to 0, if W is equals to 0, then what is my output? My output Z is equals to 0, right? And if we are focusing on the next state, what is the next state? You can see over here the diagram, the arrow is in the itself. That means my next state is the same as the present state. So my next state for the input W is equals to 0 is 00. And for that, my output Z is equals to 0. Alright? There are only two inputs, either 0 or 1. So based on that, we can see, for W is equals to 0, my state is not going to be changed. But for W is equals to 1, my state is going to be changed from 00 to 01. See over here. For W is equals to 1, S1, right? S1 means 01, and for W is equals to 1, that is written over here in this line that represents my state is going to be changed, right? For that, what is my output? My output is Z is equals to 0, alright? Now we are considering on state 1, that is S1. We are at the state 1. Now what does it mean? For that we need to consider two inputs. W is equals to 0, W is equals to 1. For W is equals to 0, my state is going to be changed to S2. What is S2? S2 is 10. For W is equals to 1, my state is not going to be changed. What is my output? My output, that is Z is equals to 0, but my state is not going to be changed. So whatever the state, if it is changed, then we need to move forward. And if it doesn't change, then we are on the same route. We are on the same state. Likewise. Okay? Now, the last case, that is S2. S2 represents AB. Its value is 10. Now from 10, we need to consider two inputs. W is equals to 0, W is equals to 1. Right? So if W is equals to 0 and 1, what is my next state? My next state is S0. That means 0, 0. Alright? Over here. Now we can see that how to draw its moving state table. Now, a state table, what it represents? From this state table, we are able to draw its K-map. And from the K-map, we are able to derive its state equation. Now, what we need to do is, you need to simply consider for a reference a state diagram. From the state diagram, we are able to derive state table. We know that there are three states, S0, S1 and S2. S0 means 00, 01 and 10, right? There are two inputs, 0 and 1, okay? Input W, which are the two states, 0 and 1, right? So next step will be A plus and B plus. And there is only one output, that is Z, right? Based on that, we need to write a state table. We need to write 00 for two state of the input 01. Again, 01, that means for two state of the input 0 and 1. For 10, again, for W is equals to 0, W is equals to 1. And last one that we haven't defined. So it is okay if we are going to write it or not. It is fine, right? Sorry. So based on the present state, what is my next state that we are going to derive from this state diagram, right? For A and B is equals to 00. What is my next state? My next state is nothing but my present state, that is 00, right? Apart from that, if W is equals to 1, sorry, then what is my next state? It is 01, right? Now, consider the third one, that is 0101 and W is equals to 0 and 1. For 01 and if W is equals to 0, what is my next state? My next state is 10. And for 01 and if my input is equals to 1, what is my next state? Next state is 01. That means it remains in the same state, right? You can see over here, the diagram. We need to write similarly for the output, either it is 0 or 1, alright? Similarly for 10, we need to write it like this, alright? For 10, input is equals to 0, input is equals to 1. Based on that, what is my next step and what is my output, alright? But for the state 4, that is 11, we haven't defined any loop and present in the next state, so it is a don't care. Alright, now how to draw a moving map? That means a K-map. Then we have already discussed how to draw K-map for 3 variable, 2 variable, 4 variable and 5 variable. Alright, so how to draw a K-map, or you can say moving map, from the state table? So first we need to do is, we are going to draw a moving map for the 3 conditions. First one is for Z, A plus, B plus. What is A plus? A plus is my next state of input. B plus is the next state of my second input. Alright, as it has a two input maps, A plus and B plus. So what it represents? It is the represents the next state, that is secondary output. Alright, Z is my primary output. We know that how to draw a K-map. So over here there are three variables. A and B is the present state. W is my input. So we need to draw it like W and AB. Right? So how to draw it? See over here. From this, we can see that for w is equals to 0 and 1, for a plus, where it represents? 1 is represented at a dash b. Alright? And for b plus, what is at where 1 is present? 1 is presented at 0, 0 and 0, 1. Right? So we can write it like this. A plus and B plus. So for A plus, my output is equals to W dash A dash B. And for input maps, B plus, that is equals to W A dash. Alright? We know that how to make a group. As there are two ones, we are making the group in horizontally. We should have to recall the rules for K-map, that we can't make a group in diagonal way. We either make horizontally or vertically. Apart from that, no single one should remain left, right? So we need to apply that rules of K-map over here. So this is the way to draw Moore map, to write state equation from the moving map. Alright? So over here, a Moore machine is finished. If you have any question, you can ask me at any time on my this email ID. Thank you for your attention.